10. Welcome, America. Welcome to Friday. Welcome to the date of 6-4, year 2010, time 6:18 a.m. Markets are going to open up, and I am going to share with you the latest payrolls. Well, for the people that want to go to the SMF blogs, why don't you go back to year 2008 there and look at all of our blogs, all of our postings, when employment used to be at 4.7, that we said it would go to 10.5%. What we are telling people is that we are a long ways away, and all of the stimulants and all of the stuff is right here. And the labor market that was implied from yesterday's weak ADP report and the lackluster, right here, lackluster jobs figures over the past 4 weeks. Non-farm payrolls increased by 431,000 in May, a disappointment from a 500,000 increase expected. However, government hires exceeded expectations by 115,000. The demand suddenly decelerates. These hires will lose their jobs quickly. Right here. They're going to lose their jobs quickly. They shouldn't have to. The only good takeaway from the non-farm payroll data was that the manufacturing payroll increased by 29,000. Its fifth consecutive monthly increase. And we had talked about this many months ago about what the U.S. needed to do in its manufacturing, and that's getting jobs back on U.S. soil. All of these jobs that went into these emerging countries for cheap labor that left the U.S. soil need to return to the safe haven, and that's only one thing and one prayer that this U.S. economy has, is to get its people working and get people back on its own shoreline, doing what it does, being innovative and creating products, manufacturing, and selling them to the rest of the world, and taking their business away and pulling it back into the U.S. coffer. Well, guess what? They better get to work. The other thing is that the unemployment rate ticked back down. This is a very deceptive number. Don't believe it. They're manufactured. Okay? May, after temporary increasing to 9.9%. Remember, people, knock, knock on my head, knock, knock on my brain, knock, knock, that elections start in November, knock, knock, knock. They're going to try to get your vote again. And if I were you, I would have some due diligence about who you vote for. Unfortunately, the number of people employed actually declined by 35,000 in May. The reason for the drop in unemployment rate was due to workers again leaving the labor market in droves. Unemployment rate leaving the labor market in droves. The labor force declined by 222,000 for the month. Its first monthly decline since December of 2009. Well, remember, the more taxpayers' dollars that went in there to try to artificially prop up this mess is that now the unwind starts to come into play. Here, on a positive note, personal incomes look stronger in May. If you believe that, then you're just about believe anything. Okay? The thing that we look at is the average hourly earnings increased 0.3%. This number here only lasts. The stimulants that your taxpayer dollars and forward-looking tax rates, this goes away. Less income, that means I'm short in retail for the next year out. Weekly hours increase 34.1 to 34 and all. If you believe that, I don't, because it doesn't, the numbers do not add up. And right here, temporary censoring hiring would push unemployment by approximately 300,000, and this is what Rick Goley was talking about right here. This is exactly what his statement was. 300,000, why other government employees would decline by 25,000. And this would leave the private payroll growth at 225,000 for the month. But let me tell you something. Stay tuned at stockmarketfunding.com. What we're here to do is try to let you know the difference between the lies, the difference between exuberance, the difference between organic, the difference between what your forward-looking years in life will look like, what the U.S. economy will be, and you could join me on SMFI on the economy on Saturday mornings at 8 o'clock Pacific Standard Time. And if I were you, I would try to find it if you see this video. Radio talk show on stockmarketfunding.com will be giving its mid-year update, and I would not miss that eye on the economy. What I am going to tell people is that non-farm payrolls increased by 431,000, and this is the headline, and I've concluded the video for the day. You want to learn more? Take responsibility. Come back, visit us. We'll do our best to help you.